We're excited to go to the movies. It's been a long time.
It's movie time again in Alberta.
We waited so long that when we went to go rent it online, it was already gone. So then the next day we found out the theaters were opening and we bought tickets.
You're not worried about all of
it? No, we're pretty. I think we'll be more spaced out in there than I am at most stores I've had to buy things at.
What do you miss?
Oh, the popcorn. I miss that popcorn.
When you go get that popcorn, you'll notice the COVID changes. Physical distancing in the theater seats, the concession line, and cleaning, cleaning, cleaning. But masks are optional.
While we fully support guests wearing masks, our staff are obviously wearing masks, and we understand the health benefits that can be attributed to that. But unless it's mandated in the overall market, I think for theaters to step out beyond and mandate that for our guests is not something that seems reasonable to us.
This infectious diseases specialist misses movies, but she's not rushing back.
I still am a bit nervous because it's, you know, shared airspace with people, with air conditioning, with, you know, a fairly long contact time.
She points out there have been no documented spreads of the virus traced to theaters, and there are ways to minimize your risk in addition to wearing masks.
I would be looking critically at the bathroom, but frankly, sometimes you have to use the bathroom, and in that case, you'd want to use it when you're distanced from other patrons in the bathroom, potentially alone if possible.
But what can you watch? Tenet was supposed to open mid-July, now it's August. And just this evening, Disney rescheduled the opening of the much-anticipated Mulan for the third time.
I think we're looking at a do-or-die situation for the old model. You know, there's a reason that theaters are pushing to open is because they are on the brink of collapse. And don't let anybody tell you differently.
After years of declining attendance, theaters are hoping customers who want to return to the way things were will help the industry survive. Eli Glasner, CBC News, Toronto.